Hey everyone, it's Steph here. Today we're on day number 20. Day 20 of our journey to a clean home in 21 days. Can you believe it? We are almost there. Today we're gonna talk about something that confused me, and I know confuses a lot of people, but it's super helpful, super effective, zone cleaning. I'm not gonna get too much into detail about zone cleaning. I'll link up here to a video that explains it way better and way more in depth, but let's just give you a quick rundown. You're going to take your home and break it up into equal sections. So I have five zones. The Fly Lady has five zones. Mine are similar to hers, but a little different. I make it work for me. And then every week you're gonna focus on deep cleaning in one of those zones. So whereas our weekly home blessing kind of covers the whole house, the main traffic areas, the zone cleaning is where you can get in and clean all those scary little nooks and crannies and all the crazy little creepy crawlies from under your couch and in your windowsills and all that stuff. I've made it a bit easier for us. I have a brand new printable. It's up on the website today, so you can go there and check it out. And basically I have the five zones all divided up with every task imaginable that you could possibly have. But if you think of something I didn't think of, there's extra spots you can fill something in. So this week for me, I'm going into zone number 4, which for me is my sweet dream zone, AKA all of my bedrooms. And so I'm just gonna work a little bit every day. I like to do 15 minutes, 4 times a week. It adds up to an hour. Sometimes I just do a full hour on Saturday. I'm gonna work in my bedrooms, just getting them deep clean. So things like windows, wiping walls, tidying the drawers and closets, cleaning the furniture, all that stuff that gets a little bit overlooked, but if you take care of it a little bit every week, it won't be hard at all. Just like with everything else, the hardest time will be the first time because it's the time it's the dirtiest. Next time you go back in there, it won't take any time because you'll just have to do a quick wipe. I'm gonna show you now how I transfer my detailed cleaning list over onto my weekly cleaning schedule so I still have everything on one page. This is just a reference for me. I'm gonna show you that right now. So if you choose to use the detailed cleaning list, great. If not, just grab your weekly cleaning schedule and write the room or rooms you're choosing to focus on in zone cleaning this week. So for me, it's the bedroom 2 or purple bedroom, which is my girls' rooms. I know I haven't been in there in a while. The last one I did was bedroom 1. So I'm gonna just write down a few of the tasks from the bedroom 2 list. So dusting sills, windows. I need to do those window screens, which I don't do all the time, but we're getting into winter, so I'm gonna do those. Lights, furniture, wash their pillows. I haven't done in a while. So just writing down all that stuff that's kind of more of a deep cleaning thing. I'm not gonna focus on getting everything on this list done. It's just a nice reference to have when I'm looking for something to do. Okay, so that's it. I hope zone cleaning doesn't scare you or intimidate you. It's really simple. If you need more of an explanation, like I say, I'll link to a little video that I go into a little bit more detail about it. I hope you just pick a few things you know need to get done in zone 4 or whatever zone you choose to be in, write them onto your weekly cleaning schedule, and then that's what you're gonna focus on this week. I will talk to you tomorrow for day 21, our last day. I've had so much fun. I cannot wait to wrap this up. So check that day 20 zone clean off. If you have time, work on it a little bit every day this week and you'll see that zone get cleaner and cleaner. Check off everything else you did and I will talk to you tomorrow. Thank you so much for joining me on this 21 days to a clean home journey. I know you're gonna see a huge difference in your house and in your life. Please remember to hit that like and subscribe button to follow along to the end of the series and let me know how you're making out with your progress.